your chest, don't you find that chrysanthemums answer the best? The Dormouse looked round at the view and replied, when he'd said 99, that he tried and he tried, and much the most answering things that he knew were geraniums red and delphiniums blue. The doctor stood frowning and shaking his head as he took up his shiny silk hat. As he said, what the patient requires is a change, and he went to see some chrysanthemum people in Kent. Thomas lay there as he gazed at the view of geraniums red and delphiniums blue, and he knew there was nothing he wanted instead of delphiniums blue and geraniums red. The doctor came back, and to show what he meant, he had brought some chrysanthemum cuttings from Kent. Now these he remarked give a much better view than geraniums red and delphiniums blue. They took out their spades and they dug up the bed of delphiniums blue and geraniums red. Chrysanthemums, yellow and white, how lovely he thought to be back in a bed of delphiniums blue and geraniums red. The doctor said, Tut, it's another attack. Ordered him milk and massage of the back. Freedom from worry and drives in a car. And murmured how sweet your chrysanthemums are. Dormouse lay there with his close to his eyes and imagined himself such a pleasant surprise. I'll pretend the chrysanthemums turn to a bed of delphiniums blue and geraniums red. The doctor next morning was rubbing his hands and saying there's nobody quite understands these cases as I do. The cure has begun. How fresh the chrysanthemums look. His eyes were so tight he could see no chrysanthemums, yellow or white, and all that he felt at the back of his head were delphiniums blue and geraniums red. That is the reason Aunt Emily said, if a Dormouse gets in a chrysanthemum bed, you'll find, so Aunt Emily says, that he lies fast asleep on his front with his paws to his eyes.